हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस कंटिन्यू द सेम चैप्टर, चैप्टर 4 ऑफ हिस्ट्री द मुगल एम्पायर। दिस इज अवर थर्ड वीडियो ऑन दिस चैप्टर एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट नूरजहां। व्हाट वाज द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ नूरजहां इन जहांगीर्स कोर्ट? व्हाट वाज हर इन्फ्लुएंस? वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इट। मेहरुनिसा मैरिड एम्परर जहांगीर। मेहरुनिसा, दिस वाज द नेम ऑफ नूरजहां। मेहरुनिसा, शी मैरिड एम्परर जहांगीर इन 1611 एंड आफ्टर दैट शी वॉज गिवन द टाइटल ऑफ नूरजहां। मेहरुनिसा हु मैरिड एम्परर जहांगीर इन 1611 एंड शी रिसीव द टाइटल नूरजहां एंड शी वॉज वेरी लॉयल एंड सपोर्टिव टू द मोनार्क और टू द किंगडम। शी वॉज वेरी सपोर्टिव एंड एज ए मार्क ऑफ ऑनर जहांगीर टू शो हर रिस्पेक्ट और टू गिव हर ऑनर जहांगीर स्ट्रक सिल्वर कॉइन्स बियरिंग हिज ओन टाइटल ऑन वन साइड ऑफ द कॉइन एंड On the other side, the inscription struck in the name of Queen Begum Noorjahan. In this way, he honored her, Noorjahan. And Jahangir gave her the title of Padsha Begum also. Jahangir gave her the title of Padsha Begum. The next one is, this is about Sulh-e-Kul. Sulh-e-Kul, the meaning of Sulh-e-Kul is universal peace. This is the meaning of Sulh-e-Kul. We will discuss about it. When Akbar was at Fatehpur Sikri during 1570s, he started discussion on religion with the ulemas or Brahmins, Jesus priest also, who were Roman Catholics and Zoroastrian. All these discussions took place in Ibadat Khana, Hidanbar, and he was very interested in the religion and social custom of the different people. After some time, Akbar's interaction with the people of different faiths or religion, it made him realize that religious scholars who emphasized the ritual and dogma, all those people were bigots. And their teaching created division and disharmony between his subjects. And this eventually led to the idea of Sulh-e-Kul or universal peace. Now, this idea of tolerance, it did not discriminate or differentiate between people of different religions in his kingdom or realm. Akbar led to the idea of Sulh-e-Kul and this idea of tolerance, it did not discriminate or differentiate between people of different religions in his kingdom or realm. And it focused on a system of ethics. The meaning of ethics is moral values. This system, universal peace or Sulh-e-Kul, it focused on the system of ethics, honesty, justice and peace. It focused on it. Honesty, justice and peace. And that was universally applicable to all the people. It was applied to all the people. And this principle of governance, it was followed by son Jahangir also. This principle of Sulh-e-Kul, it was followed by Jahangir and Shahjahan as well. That was about Sulh-e-Kul or universal peace. Now the main terms of this chapter, first one is dogma, second one is bigot. What is dogma? It is a statement. Dogma means it is a statement which is declared as authoritative or with power. This is declared with power with the expectation that it would be followed without any question. Nobody will ask any question. And this will be declared as authoritative or with power with the expectation, with the hope that it would be followed without any question. This is called dogma. And the second main term is bigot. Bigot means it's an individual who is intolerant of another person's religious faith or culture. And a person or an individual who is intolerant of another person's religious feelings, culture or belief, that is called a bigot. That was about bigot.